You've probably heard about dual wall insulated bottles, but what about triple wall? If two walls are good, then three are better, right? Let's find out. Dual wall stainless steel bottles have been around for a long time, and brands like Hydro Flask and Yeti really launched them into mainstream use within the last decade. Each bottle has two walls of stainless steel with a vacuum in between, and the lack of air reduces how much heat can transfer in or out. We tested quite a few of these bottles for a video earlier this year, and that turned into one of our best performing posts. Triple wall bottles are not as widespread, but there are a few brands out there marketing this type of design, including Swell, Revomax, EcoVessel, and Owala. We didn't discuss this type of bottle as much as we would have liked in our previous insulation test video, so we thought now would be a good time to revisit it, this time with a focus on seeing if the triple wall design is worth the marketing hype. As always, we'll have links to the products in the description. If you make a purchase after clicking the link, we make a small referral fee. It doesn't cost you anything extra, and every little bit helps our small business. We really appreciate the support. Before we get started, there are a few details to point out. First, in our previous video, we weighed ice before and after to determine how much of it had melted. This time, we're doing a hot water test and using a thermometer to measure temperature. We changed this up to try to make the test more reliable, and because insulation is the resistance to temperature change in either direction, it doesn't matter if we're testing hot or cold, we should get the same relative results and rankings for each bottle. Second, most of the bottles we tested hold 32 ounces, but we have a few other bottles that we wanted to test too. We also had a couple of bottles that are narrow mouth instead of wide mouth. For an ideal test, all of the bottles would have the same volume and the same mouth opening diameter. We're a small channel that can only afford to buy so many bottles, so we're working with what we have. That being said, our results will still give you a pretty good idea of what to expect, especially if you're looking for a 32 ounce size. Third, different lids have different insulating properties. Because our primary goal is to test the insulation differences between dual and triple walls, we wanted to remove the variable of the lid design from our test. More on this later. And finally, the term triple wall is a bit misleading. We're going to spend a couple minutes geeking out about thermodynamics to explain how it works, so skip ahead to this point in the video if you'd like to move straight to the test. Many people assume triple wall means three walls of stainless steel, but that's not correct. If you look closely at the marketing and listings, you'll notice that it probably says triple layer instead of triple wall. It's a small but significant distinction because they don't really have three walls. They have the same dual wall construction with a vacuum in between, and the third layer refers to a copper coating on one of the stainless steel walls. You might be wondering how this could help. Copper is known for being a good electrical conductor, but it also has a high thermal conductivity. This means that heat is transferred very easily through it, so why would a copper layer help bottle insulation? The answer comes down to the three basic types of heat transfer: conduction, convection, and radiation. Conduction is the transfer of energy from one molecule to another through direct contact. Matter is needed since you need the molecules to touch each other, so this is the type of heat transfer that the vacuum seal really helps with. Convection is heat transfer related to the movement of a fluid, such as water. This does not apply as much to our situation since we're focusing on sealed bottles. The third method is radiation, and this is where the copper layer is designed to help. Radiation is the transfer of heat by electromagnetic waves. Examples include sunlight, incandescent light bulbs, irons, and toasters. The key difference with radiation compared to either conduction or convection is that radiation does not need matter to transfer heat, which allows for heat loss through the vacuum in dual wall bottles. Emissivity is a material property that indicates how efficiently heat is transferred by radiation. A material with a lower emissivity value will transfer less radiant heat compared to a material with a higher value. Think about those shiny Mylar emergency blankets. They're made of thin layers of plastic with an even thinner layer of aluminum. which creates the shiny appearance. Aluminum has an emissivity of 0.05, so it does a very good job of limiting radiation heat transfer. Copper also has an emissivity of 0.05, so while the copper coating won't do much to prevent heat conduction, it will help prevent heat radiation. For reference, stainless steel has a higher emissivity of 0.59, so the steel alone won't prevent radiation heat loss as efficiently by itself. So that's the science behind the triple layer and how it theoretically is better. But how does this translate into actual results, and is it significant enough of a difference for you to consider when buying a bottle? Let's get down to the test. We looked at 14 total bottles. 11 bottles are dual wall and 3 have triple layer insulation with the copper coating. As mentioned before, different lids have different insulating properties. Because our main goal was to compare the triple layer versus dual wall insulation, we wanted to keep the different lid styles from impacting the results as much as possible. We purchased a sheet of styrofoam insulation, cut it into a bunch of smaller pieces, and pressed them onto the rim of the bottles. This created an impression in the styrofoam pieces that helped limit the potential for gaps in temperature loss. We poked a hole through each piece of foam with our thermometer, and we used a few other smaller pieces of insulation to cover up the holes when we weren't taking measurements. We were originally going to boil water to recreate steeping tea or brewing coffee, but it would have taken quite a few batches and taken a lot longer. So instead, we filled up each bottle with the hottest water from our sink. We measured the temperature for every hour for the next 4 hours, again around hour 8, and one more time around hour 20. With each measurement, we inserted the thermometer through the hole in the styrofoam cap until the temperature equalized. This chart and graph show the percentage temperature change at different times during the test, which lasted 19 hours and 31 minutes. Temperature drops ranged between 17.2% on the low end to 27.0% on the high end. Looking closer at the data, there are a few interesting results to note. Two of the triple layer bottles, RevoMax and Swell, had the best results. The third triple layer bottle, EcoVessel, didn't fare as well, but it was still in the top five. The best dual wall bottle really surprised us. Ozark Trail, the Walmart bottle brand that we bought for $11, had an 18.5% temperature loss. Compare that to 20.9% for a $50 Yeti Rambler and 24.2% for a $45 Hydro Flask. The worst bottle by a wide margin is Steepware, which is a bit ironic given that it's primarily made for brewing tea. That being said, it's probably not a major concern because most people will drink the tea within a few hours before it goes stale. Based on these results, it does appear that the copper layer may have an impact and helps insulation. However, depending on which brands you're comparing, the difference between triple layer and dual wall insulation might not be as great as you would have thought. When you average the percent temperature loss for dual wall versus triple layer bottles, you get 22.7% and 18.3% respectively. A 5% difference over 20 hours is significant, but it's not really game changing in our opinion. However, there's another big variable that makes this conclusion a bit uncertain. We can't afford to buy every type of bottle, and it just so happens with our bottle collection that the two best performing bottles were also our only two narrow mouth bottles. Because most heat is lost through the lid and mouth opening, narrow mouth bottles should have an advantage over wide mouth ones. We'd like to do another test in the future that focuses on wide mouth versus narrow mouth insulation once we have more narrow mouth bottles to compare. But let's face it, you're not going to be walking around with one of these bottles with a styrofoam cap. We did the test first because we wanted to isolate the effect that the copper layer has on the insulation, but the more practical test that you can use compares the bottles when using the lids that they come with. So we ran a second version of this test using the bottle lids. For each measurement, we swapped the bottle lid with the styrofoam piece from the previous test. Then we pushed the thermometer through the styrofoam, and this prevented excessive temperature loss for the 15 to 20 seconds that we needed for each measurement. Once we had the reading, we put the normal cap back on. This test lasted for 19 hours and 17 minutes, and we made the same type of chart and table to show the results. Right away, there are some interesting data points and details to unpack. The relative rankings were mostly the same as with test A, but there was a much wider range of results with a 13.5% temperature drop on the low end to 30.1% on the high end. That's an increase in the range of results from 9.8% with test A to 16.6% with test B. The same two brands performed the best, but they widened their lead significantly. However, keep in mind that these are the only two narrow mouth bottles in our test. Ozark Trail had a great showing again, and this was the best dual wall bottle for both tests. Unfortunately for Steepware, this bottle was even more of an outlier on the wrong side of the average compared to test A. While the relative rankings were similar for both tests, you may have noticed that the rankings did change in some cases. For example, Hydro Flask's Trail series jumped from the second worst with test A to the middle of the pack with test B. Since the only change between the two tests was that we switched from the standardized foam pieces to each brand's lid, any changes in the rankings means that some brands have designed lids with better insulation than others. Tests A and B had slightly different total durations, so to better illustrate how the results for each bottle changed between the tests, we needed to standardize the results. We calculated the temperature drop per minute over the duration of both tests, then we multiplied that by 1200 to simulate a 20-hour test. Then we compared test A to test B for each brand, and this table shows how each brand changed. Bottles that fall on the left side had better results with their brand's lids instead of the styrofoam cap, and bottles on the right did better with the styrofoam. Swell, RevoMax, and both Hydro Flasks were the only bottles that improved with test B. When you look at the lids with each of these bottles, you can see that they seem to have more built-in insulation, like with Hydro Flask's honeycomb design. Most of the other bottle lids don't have built-in insulation and just have a single layer plastic construction in the cap, so it's understandable that they didn't fare as well. So when we take a step back to look at the results as a whole, we have a few main takeaways. First, the triple layer construction does seem to help compared to dual wall insulation. However, it may not be as big of a difference maker on its own as the marketing might make you think. Second, the bigger factor appears to be narrow versus wide mouth and the insulating properties of each brand's lid design. Third, the price doesn't guarantee results, as Ozark's $11 bottle did better than all of the other dual wall bottles, including Yeti and Hydro Flask. Based on these results, we have a few more video ideas that we may work on in the near future. Once we have more narrow mouth bottles in our collection, we want to compare those against wide mouth bottles. We also think it would be interesting to focus on premium brands versus budget brands, because let's face it, we're probably not the only ones that were surprised that Ozark Trail outperformed Yeti. And finally, we only ran one instance of each test. For more reliable comparisons and data, we ideally would repeat this test more times and average the results. Let us know which video you'd like to see in the comments, and we're also open to suggestions. Again, the product links are in the description. If you're still listening here, consider giving us a like or leaving a comment, or subscribe if you're interested to learn more about hydration and the ever-expanding world of water bottles. Thanks for watching. Bye.